I mean, it's difficult to know where to start, and of course that's part of the problem that is faced by ordinary human beings out there trying to do simple things like put a roof over their head. How simple these things were once upon a time, but now when you try and put a roof over your head, you're faced with problems that are summed up with paragraphs like this in the guide we were given by the Oireachtas report, the research guides, the Oireachtas Library and Research Service, very helpful guides that are given to TDs about these bills. But I just love this stuff. In short, the institutions that typically purchase loan books in order to service them are structured in such a way that the legal entity which employs people to service said loan books is a separate entity than the one that owns the loan book. This means that the owner of the loan book would be regulated, but the entity that interacts with the customer would not be. It's like something from a science fiction novel. In fact, it wouldn't be a bad first paragraph in a science fiction novel, because you're not dealing with human beings anymore. You're not dealing with the bank manager down the road. You're not dealing with any sort of substantial being. You're dealing with an entity that is also a special purpose vehicle. I don't know if you've ever read Ian Banks' Minister. He's a fantastic Scottish science fiction novelist who used science fiction and space opera as an analogy for the madness of modern capitalism and the big spaceships that sort of dominated the universe in his books. They were also called SPVs. That's exactly where we're at. SPVs floating around the global financial markets, looking for opportunities to make money. Nobody knows who's driving these vehicles. They're just entities. But these entities are swooping down on the mortgage books of the poor, unsuspecting human being who lives in an estate somewhere in Dublin or Cork, who's just trying to put a roof over their head with extreme difficulty, who's been battered by the consequences of the financial madness and corporate gambling of the last 10 or 20 years. And then down from outer space comes the SPV, driven by the entity who is not regulated by anything and who nobody knows or understands, but who will soon have control of your mortgage. I mean, it's totally bizarre. Totally bizarre. And, you know, when you ask, how did we get here? Have we learned any lessons about the mess that we are in and the causes of that mess and how we got to this pass? You just have to read this stuff and know we've learned absolutely nothing whatsoever. Nothing. We're just about to do it again. I was just reading the Irish Times there is from January. January 19th, yeah. Record year for investment in Irish commercial property. Investment in Irish commercial property reached a record high in 2014 with some $4.5 billion invested. This represents a 25% increase on the previous peak of $3.6 billion reached in 2006. Oh my God. Oh my God. We are now surpassing the level of gambling in the property market in Ireland that we had in 2006, 2 years before an absolutely catastrophic crash that beggared the nation, for which we, our children and our grandchildren will be paying the cost with this unsustainable debt that has been loaded onto their backs and the crushing austerity and injustice and unfairness and inequality that goes with it. And it's almost funny, except, you know, if you look at it at that sort of science fiction level, but when you get down to the human reality underneath this, it's not funny at all. It's tragic. It's terrible. It produces anxiety and worry and terror and uncertainty and homelessness and the loss of homes and evictions. That's how it translates down at the level of human reality. This would not be necessary, you know, because you will say, oh, well, this bill is actually trying to extend a little bit of regulation on to the entity and the SPV that's floating out there somewhere in the financial markets, hoovering up the spaceship that's out there, hoovering up mortgage books and loans. So at least we're trying to extend some sort of regulation to it, to this madness. But, of course, the problem is that we allowed this to take place in the first place. After what happened in 2006 and 2007 and 2008, we have facilitated the handover, and you, Minister, and your government have facilitated the handover of these loan books, of people's mortgages, real human beings' mortgages, to these SPVs and these entities. You've allowed that to happen. And then after the fact, you say, oh my God, we better do something to regulate it because our central bank regulations don't cover it. Now, of course, the irony of all this is that the code of conduct of mortgage arrears you're trying to extend to these entities and SPVs or their credit servicing firms, sorry, I forgot about them because it's even more complicated. It's not the SPV that we can actually regulate. We can't regulate them because they're not a bank. So we've got to regulate the service company that they have employed in order to manage and administer the mortgage. You know, it just gets more liberantine as we go along. We don't know who we're dealing with. So actually, we're not dealing with the SPV. We're not dealing with the entity driving the SPV, but we're dealing with, a shuttle ship that has been sent off the main spaceship down to planet Earth to pick up the mortgage loan. I mean, it is totally, totally bizarre and mad. But you have facilitated this by allowing the sale of these loan books. When, of course, many of these mortgage holders said, any chance we could just buy our own mortgage back? No. Couldn't have that. We couldn't have a simple thing like somebody would be able to buy their own mortgage. So there's some relationship, you know, to real human beings and the things they need, which is a secure roof over their head, some knowledge of, like, who owns the loan. No, that would be far too simple. No, instead, we've got to sell it to the subcontractor of the entity in the spaceship. You know, why? And what is now being revealed, of course, the latest shocking revelation in all this, because, of course, I mean, there is a logic behind it from your point of view, is let's sell off all these things as quick as we can, get some cash back, so we can say we have recovered some of the costs of the shocking and outrageous and unfair bailout of the banks and the financial institutions, so that you can put out a statement, as you've put out many, saying, oh no, we've covered the cost of the bank bailout, NAMA's going to pay for itself, it's all fine, really, we've done a wonderful job. But of course, the truth is, the country is being sold out under our feet. The mortgage books are being sold out under our feet. The property assets are being sold out under our feet to the spaceships, to the SPVs, to the vultures, the alien entities out there who don't give a damn about the human beings here, don't give a damn about our economy, don't give a damn about whether people have roofs over their heads, who are just in it for making money. You know, God, it's amazing. I'm actually getting nostalgic. As a socialist, I'm getting nostalgic for the old-fashioned bank. Because now we have these entities who aren't even the old-fashioned banks, so you could go down. I mean, I've been at the Ulster Bank for years, I'm a socialist. I want to nationalise all these banks, but now I've got a real nostalgia for the old days when you could go down to the Ulster Bank in Blackrock and you actually could talk to a human being. And yet, there was some actual accountability. No, we don't have that now. We're going to talk to the subcontractor of the Vulture Fund in the special purpose vehicle. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you call the bank in BlackRock, and you get a call centre in Scotland, who will then reroute it. Oh, Scotland, I get Scotland, and then it's rerouted back to BlackRock. He'll send you a text. It's beyond belief. So, what I would say, Minister, is, you know, this is just going to make no difference. It's absolute decoration, right? It's total decoration. Because, of course, even in the code of conduct of mortgage arrears, you know, when you boil it all down, and I missed, because government speakers, I believe, didn't turn up for the last debate. I was supposed to speak at 3:30 on the personal insolvency legislation. That's what it said on my thing. But government speakers didn't turn up, so the whole thing fell this morning. But you see, it comes back to all that, and it comes back, indeed, this is at a micro level, what's happening in Greece and the debate with Syriza and the government is... Why do these big financial entities, the bondholders, the SPVs, the entities, their subcontractors, whatever the hell you want to call them, or the creditors, in terms of people's personal indebtedness, they, in the end, called the shots? Yeah.
Government speakers that didn't turn up. In actual fact, it was some of the opposition speakers that didn't turn up, as I well know. Because I was waiting to speak.
That's not what our office told us, because I had a schedule which I can show you here, which had me down to speak at 3:30, and about 6 or 7 speakers didn't turn up, and I was told they were from the government side, which is very unfortunate, seeing as we are dealing with the very important issue of personal insolvency. But in any event, it relates to this. So the same central points can be made, because in the last analysis, you have continued here in this country in terms of personal indebtedness, here in this country in terms of the way the banks operate, and now in terms of these entities, in the last analysis, these guys call the shots. They decide whether they're going to turf you out or whether they're not going to turf you out, right? That's the bottom line. They decide. They call the shots. And you have allowed this to happen and believe that it's just inevitable. And I just think, when is the government going to get with the programme of what is starting to happen in the rest of Europe? Because the pendulum is swinging against this approach to dealing with the problem. And it's not because of some charismatic individual called Alex Tsipras in Greece. It's because the people of Greece have had enough. They've had 26 general strikes, and eventually, after everybody else let them down, they found some organisation that said, we'll stick with you, and we'll actually call these people on the madness that is being inflicted on us. And now that's spreading to Spain. We're seeing echoes of it in this country with the water movement, which isn't just about the water, as the Taoiseach rightly spotted. It's about everything. It's about this stuff. It's about the housing crisis. It's about being battered, having no money, about the threat of eviction from your home, about the diktat of the bondholders and the SPVs and the entities in the financial markets, and just having enough of this and saying, sorry, could you remember the human beings? Could you remember us, the simple things we need? A secure roof over our head, a decent wage packet at the end of the week, so we're not the working poor, that when we go to the hospital, we won't be on a trolley for a week, or on a waiting list for an operation for 2 years. What about those things?
You were entertaining for a while there. Yeah. I begin to wander off the bin now, and I think we'd ask you to steer back in the same course that you were on the beginning.
Yes, I'm saying, Cathaoirleach, that we wouldn't have to worry about the things that this bill is worrying about, which is the sale of people's mortgage loans and other loans to entities and special purpose vehicles, otherwise known as vulture funds, if we weren't flogging off the family silver, flogging off those loans, selling off literally the city and the property, and, you know, we're flogging the country as we speak, billions worth of loans and property being flogged off to the very same people who helped pump up the property market in the first place. And it's just beyond belief. And where the levels of gambling in this area have now surpassed the levels that they were at in 2006. And I just wonder, you know, like, at what point do we say we got to stop the madness? The people of Europe and the people of this country are saying, could we please stop the madness? Because it is an accident waiting to happen again. And all of this, you know, translates at the level of this bill down to the poor unfortunate person who won't know who owns the loan and their mortgage, who they're dealing with, and in any event, well, they're now the beneficiary of a code of conduct on mortgage arrears that doesn't make a blind bit of difference anyway to the people for whom it currently applies. In the end, the creditors decide. They get the veto, they decide. We'll do a deal with you if we feel like it, if it suits us, if we can make money out of it, but if we don't, tough luck. And you've got to be evicted. And who picks up the bill? Well, we see that with the spiralling social housing lists. Gone absolutely out of control. And this is the false economy of all this stuff, of flogging these loan books off, flogging off all the NAMA assets. The false economy is, oh yeah, the minister can announce, oh, NAMA's going to make a profit. Or the banks have repaid us the money. Yeah, but we've got 10,000 more families now on the social housing list, many of whom are threatened with homelessness, and we're going to have to pay for that with rent allowance or new leasing arrangements called housing assistant payments. Who will we be paying them to, Minister? Who will the taxpayers' money, the housing assistant payments, the 75,000 housing assistant payments, where will the money be going? What is it, €750,000? Approximately we'll be forking out to these guys. It'll be going to the entities. It'll be going to the special purpose vehicles. That's who it'll be going to. It's just beyond madness. Beyond madness. And I think probably in your heart of hearts, Minister, you know it. And certainly Europe is waking up to it. The wind is changing across Europe. And what was the line from Bob Dylan? What?
Black rain will fall.
But the times are changing. Get out of the way if you can't. What's that line? Get out of the way if you can't stand the heat or whatever the line is. People have to change now because it hasn't worked. It hasn't worked, Minister, and this stuff is just, you know, it's not even a sticking plaster. It's just purely decorative, meaningless stuff covering up the fact of insane continued gambling in the financial markets, of a property market that has now been totally cut loose from reality, from any consideration of the human beings around whom these decisions and these movements of money and financial considerations and profit considerations, the human beings they affect. Just been cut loose. You should read, actually, another thing that's worth reading as well as Ian Banks is Jonathan Swift, Gulliver's Travels, the third book of Gulliver's Travels. Very, very similar phenomena he's describing.
Once again, you are most entertaining, but there's certainly nothing about Gulliver's Travels in the bill.
There's entities floating above the country.
No, there's not.
Controlled by crazy people making decisions affecting the human beings down below.
So the best teachers...